Hello there, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Pokemon Legends Arceus. We're going to fight Kleavor today. Are we ready to fight Kleavor is the thing. Well, first things first, let's claim our points here. Because these are good for if you want to get evolutionary items in this game. Lost and found is what I meant to do. Alright, we got 97 points, and you basically can trade in those points for evolutionary items. Now then, ready yourself, and I will summon our mighty Kleavor, Lord of the Woods. Alright. As am I. Oh, mighty Kleavor, Lord of the Woods. Though it isn't yet the time of ceremony, we've prepared an offering of your favorite things. Benevolent Lord who works his might between the heavens and earth, we offer our gratitude and beseech you, reveal yourself to our eyes. Listen well, keep your focus on Kleavor. Dodging will be vital. Try to avoid his moves as you're throwing the balms. Rashaw! All right, Kleavor, here we go. Here we go. All right. I get it. Let me out of this. Run to the tree, Kleavor. There we go. Fun fact, you actually don't need to have any Pokemon to go into battle to beat Kleavor. You just need it to keep running into the tree. Oh boy, not that close. Okay, well, that was me facing the wrong direction is what that was. Doesn't change how I'm approaching this fight. Just look the right way next time, stupid. There we go. Much better. See? It worked out that time. Barely got out of it that time. Oh boy! I'm gonna need to dodge better this time because he's not stuck behind the tree now. There we go. I'm alright. Still alright. Alright, almost done. Look at that, didn't even need a Pokemon. Alright, Kleavor goes down. Hi, Kleavor. Everyone leveled up, even though they didn't do anything. That's funny. Got the insect plate, or the bug plate, for those that couldn't make that connection. Alright. Kleavor's gonna run back off now, all happy and back to normal. What happened? Some kind of light erupted from Kleavor's body. Has Lord Cleavor's frenzied mind truly been put at ease now?
Does this confirm that the strange lightning was to blame for Cleavor's unnatural power? Well, this is what I think. After all we've seen, we know strange lightning came from out of the space-time rift the other night. Those bolts must have struck Cleavor and driven him into his frenzy after all.
The lightning came from the space-time rift? But if Almighty Sinnoh really does dwell beyond the space-time rift, then the strange lightning, it indeed was Almighty Sinnoh's power? Then were we even right to try to interfere? I happily went along with this plan to create some bombs as if I knew what I was doing. Like some kind of thoughtless fool. Outrageous.
Calm yourself, Leon. Remember that the Lord of the Woods has long been our protector, keeping the Pearl Clan safe from dangerous Pokemon that might harm us. Would power sent by the true Almighty Sinnoh have driven Cleavor to turn on us and attack people and Pokemon indiscriminately? I doubt it. What Travis accomplished just now, it needed to be done. I'm glad we could settle this without further strife with the Diamond Clan or the Galaxy Team. If you come across another Pokemon in the grip of this painful frenzy, please help them.
Yes, fine, I suppose I must concur. I apologize for becoming briefly incomposed. I'm grateful for what you've done for my lord. Please take these on behalf of the Pearl Clan.
Consider it my apology for having spoken rudely to you earlier, and a token of my thanks.
Oh boy, 3 citrus berries. Yippee-dee. Alright.
Let me care for your Pokemon as well, in appreciation for fighting on our behalf.
Alright. I think I've finally come to believe that you truly did fall out of the sky. Though I still cannot imagine the reasons at play. And it seems we've settled things here. Though, between you and me, I wouldn't mind seeing Lord Cleavor in such a frenzy again. He was fearfully strong, after all. Okie dokie. Before we head back, let me put stuff in storage. Since we are working with limited space, we got a Firestone out of that. I didn't mean to put the Oranberry back, but I did. There we go. That way we keep it near the front there. All right. Caught 3 Pokemon during my adventure there. All right. And there are 2,000 points. I mean, I'm sorry, we're at 2,000 points. And there are 240 points. All right. You've quelled Lord Cleavor, you say. Well done. Bravo. Time to head back to the village and report to Commander Kamado. We also need to report to Silene and get our rank changed. Oh, hi, Volo. I saw the light fading into the sky. You must have quelled the Lord Pokemon. And what do you have there? Could it be? Ah, those are 2 of the fabled plates of old. Please let me have a look. I see, there are some letters carved into them. Let's see, this one says, where all creation was born, that is the being's place of origin. It seems to be a phrase from a very old myth. How'd you come across these?
Also, Pokemon gave it to me.
I see, so you were given the plates when you impressed Weirdear and Cleavor.
This is quite something indeed. My heart is practically racing with excitement.
It is my guess that you will find more plates like these scattered across Hisui. If we were to gather them all and decipher the scripts on them, we may uncover something. Absolutely amazing. The mysteries of the past Oh, how they tickle my curiosity. What a joy to be alive in such times. Well, I must be on my way. Until next time. All right, Volo. Are you selling stuff yet? You are, but it's just Pokeballs. Good to know, though. Let's go here first, I hope. Nope. Oh, okay, yes, they did let me. Okay. So I should be 2 stars now. Yay! With this, you have officially attained the rank of 2nd star. We can now use Feather Balls, and Pokemon up to level 30 will obey us. Alright. Feather Balls are awesome. They're good for catching Pokemon from far away. Much more handy than the Heavy Balls, in my opinion. Alright, time to talk to Commander Kamado.
Well done. I have already received the reports of your exploits. You successfully quelled Cleavor's frenzy, restoring peace of mind to Hisui's people. You are a stranger to us, one who fell out of the very sky, yet you have served the galaxy team admirably. I admit you have earned yourself some degree of recognition. But things are not settled yet. I've received word that there are other Pokemon nobles falling prey to such frenzies elsewhere in Hisui. So carry on with your research and survey duties, and prove that you truly are an asset to us. That is all. You are dismissed. Your fellow Survey Corps members are likely at the Wallflower. Go and join them.
The frenzy of the Lord of the Woods is complete. All right. Benny Old Chum, the usual order, 3 servings of potato mochi, please. Do these people eat anything other than potato mochi? Oh, and if there's anything else that you'd recommend, by all means, bring it out. The whole village is gossiping up a storm about our young friend here, you know. She's got quite some luck to have come back unharmed after facing off against that Cleavor. I dare say... Travis was well prepared, and she was a quick study of how Cleavor moved in battle, from what I heard. All in all, it was a very good show, a victory well earned. Going to work in the field lands should feel a lot safer now, thanks to you, Travis. And if you want to feel even safer, try making some of these. Benny taught me how to make them, so I wrote out his directions into a recipe. Smoke bombs. I don't think I used a smoke bomb once my entire first playthrough. Lovely. And now that we need not worry about being mauled by Cleavor either, let's take our chance to study all the Pokemon that call the Obsidian Fieldlands their home. Travis. I've been waiting for you, Travis. My name's Vessa. I'm not going to spoil anything, but I get the name now after my first playthrough. There's something real important I need to tell you. Would you come with me? This is kind of a secret, but something terrible has happened. Hisui is in a whole lot of danger. Hundreds of years ago, a being that brought calamity to this region was sealed away by someone using the power of a strange magic. But now, for some unknown reason, the magic has come undone and the seal is broken. I hate to think what might happen at this rate. So please, Travis, hear me out. I need you to restore the broken seal. I don't believe you. Yeah, I guess that's a normal response to hearing such a strange story. I must sound crazy, but you just have to believe me.
Can I give you this odd keystone anyway? It'll help you see what I'm telling the truth. Alright. After the seal was broken, a whole bunch of wisps scattered across Hisui. 107 of them in total. With the odd keystone I gave you, you'll be able to gather them all. See, the wisps are normally invisible, but not to the holder of the odd keystone. I know it's a huge task, but please, you must have to gather all of the wisps for me. There's one real close to where we are now. How about you start with that one? See the flame hovering over there? Try touching it. Wait, Travis, where are you going? You need to touch the wisp. Okay, so I have to gather that one. Okay. I probably won't do the wisp on in the recordings. But here's one. We'll see. I haven't decided on that one yet or not. Some of it will depend on how long this series gets. Or if I want to go about getting all of them again. The wisp has been absorbed into the odd keystone, just as it should have been. Thank goodness I picked you to help me with this. Come talk to me if you ever need help finding the remaining wisp. And one last thing, as you gather more and more wisp, I'll give you some rewards as thanks. I'll wait here for you while you carry out your search. Good luck. Yep, that's a side request. It is required if you want to catch Spiritomb. Like I said, I haven't decided yet, but I do have more than one Spiritomb on my first playthrough file. So if I wanted to, I could send one over here if I wanted to skip the searching. We'll see. Wow, the Galaxy Team hairdresser really is, dare I say, cutting edge. Oh, hey, you're Travis, the person who quelled Cleavor, aren't you? Yeah. I knew it. You've got quite the reputation, you know. I mean, you quelled one of Almighty Sinnoh's chosen ones. Some people are actually kind of scared of you for doing something so bold. I'm a Reizu, by the way. I'm a warden of the Diamond Clan. My special skill is giving haircuts. Real nice to meet you. Oh, snip. But I came here to talk to your Mr. Kamado. See you around. Sounds like I gotta talk to Mr. Kamado. Do I have to do that quest? I don't really want to. Okay. Hey, there we go. We did just have to wait. Alright, I will do that one.
So it's come to Ursaluna as well. This suggests that even Pokemon that are not nobles can become frenzied. I have received no word from Adamant or Irida, but this is not something we can simply ignore. In any case, you have my thanks, Miss Arisu. You did well to inform us of Ursaluna's situation.
No problem. Adamant's got his hands full running our clan and all, and Ursaluna's warden wouldn't even give me the time of day. So the Galaxy Team are the only ones I could turn to about this.
Ursaluna's warden is Mistress Kalaba of the Pearl Clan, is it not? Of all the wardens, she is the most narrow-minded, bound by tradition. She likely does not take kindly to outsiders meddling in her affairs. I have a new mission for you, Travis. I order you to study Ursaluna in the Crimson Mirelands. I permit you to show your strength if necessary.
Okie dokie.
The next area you will be sent to investigate is the Crimson Mirelands. You'll find the Pokemon living there to be more fearsome than those in the Obsidian Fieldlands. Even the landscape itself is harsher, with steep ravines and seaside cliffs. It is not welcoming. At your current rank, you should be able to handle the Crimson Mirelands on your own. Here's what you need to know. Your destination is a place within the Mirelands known as the Salacion Ruins. That is where you'll find Ursaluna's Warden. Okie dokie again. What's my team look like again? And I'll just stick with what we got. If they don't force me to the Mirelands, I'll go do the shiny Ponyta first. If they force me to the Mirelands, we're just going to continue on. Hey, Travis, mind helping me train a bit? Sure. That's the stuff. I'll feel a lot better going out researching on my own if I can beat you. All right, Ray. Flame Wheel. Bye, Mime Jr. All right. Quick Attack and Thunder Wave, huh? Flame Wheel. Paralyzed. Flame Wheel. Almost got it. Alright, Quilava goes down again. Well, I know that some of these are weak to Pikachu, but for the sake of we just need to hit it one more time to win, why not? Go Psyduck. Water Pulse. I don't know why I thought it said Water Gun in a previous video. Alright, we win. Oh boy, Pikachu's gonna be angry with me again. Alright. Seems right that the one who could defeat a lord would beat me too, I guess. Thanks for that battle. Here, let me give you a new recipe. Stealth sprays. I also didn't use any of those in my first playthrough. You know, lately these space-time distortion things have been popping up here and there. I took a peek into one and saw some tempting items, so I tried ducking in to grab them. But it turned out there were legions of tough Pokemon inside. I barely made it out alive. You be careful. You be careful around those distortions, all right? There are some Pokemon you can only catch in the distortions. So, if you see one, charge right in. The items are nice too, but charge right in to get some of those Pokemon. Alright, we can go anywhere we want, so we're going to go here first. I don't think I had to talk to anyone first about Ponyta. We'll see. If I'm wrong, then we'll go back to town. It wouldn't be the first time I was inaccurate on something. Yep, okay. Back to town we go, yay. All right. Let's go talk to whoever we gotta talk to about Ponyta. I remember, I think it's a guy that's up here on this bridge over here. Yep.
You're here about my Ponyta request, right? Glad to have some help at last. Here's the problem. A Ponyta like no one's ever seen before has appeared in the Horseshoe Plains. It looks so different than the other Ponyta, it's a little scary to be honest. Well, I told the professor, he got all excited about researching it, so we agreed to have the Ponyta surveyed and see what's what. If you'd head to the Horseshoe Plains and catch that strange Ponyta for us, it'd really help us out. Okay. Actually, while I'm here, can I get any better moves for anybody? Not really. Alright, never mind. We're just gonna live with what we got. I am gonna reorganize the moves for Quilava, though, since it is gonna stay on the team. Alright. Looks good to me. Alright, fast travel over here. You're not going to be able to see the town if I keep ignoring the request. That's kind of funny. Alright, let's try this again. Let's go get the Ponyta. And after we get the free shiny, I will continue with the story missions. And of course, on our way there, we'll stop and pick up all these apricorns. Uh-oh. I think we're having a very slight... Nope, we're good. For a minute there, I thought my computer... I thought we were having a disconnect there. Being out of sync and all that. All right, let's see. There it is. It's our Ponyta. Hi, Ponyta. How you doing? It's an unusual Ponyta. Is it on the other side of the water? Where did they say it was? Oh, I see, it's over there. I think you can literally, like, run up to it and catch it. Save, just in case I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure you can just, like, run up and smack it in the face of the Pokeball. Hi. Hi there. You're mine now. There we go. We've got our Ponyta. That was the only thing we came here to do, was to get that Ponyta. Huh. All right. So let's keep going. I missed. There we go. Yep, we caught one Pokemon, the shiny, the free shiny. Return to the village. Yeah, sadly, you have to go back to the village before you can go to other locations. That's probably the one nitpick, but that's okay. All right, now we can go here. I'll get the reward or whatever for completing the quest another time. The Crimson Mirelands. Mirelands. More Pokemon to go catch. Here we are, my girl, the Crimson Mirelands. an area teeming with poison-wielding Pokemon, and plenty of others besides. Seems like you're in for a tough mission. I'm sure you can handle it, though. Oh, that's right. You're heading to the Salacion Ruins, aren't you? They're off that way. If you need a pointer, see the entrance way over there. Yep, I can see it already. It's literally at the top of that path. All right. You know, I wish we could tell where or when one of those space-time distortions was going to erupt. I wonder if checking the map would help. Yep, okay. I'm counting on both of you to carry out your survey work as best you can. Be mindful of your limitation as well, won't you? Limitations, that is. If wild Pokemon are giving you trouble, I suggest you go to the training grounds. Okay. I don't think they will, but good to know. Hey, Budu. You're mine now. Alright. We've already got Psyduck. A Carnivine. Come get the berry, Carnivine. Alright, try again. We got a Carnivine. Well, I see Paris. We've already got a Paris. Alright. Okay, so that was it for that direction. Now we go back this way. Get all the Pokemon we can get on this side, and then we'll cross the bridge. Alright, that is actually it, because we've already got Psyduck. I kind of forgot we had Psyduck already. Alright, in that case, well, wait a minute, we got this. This could be something different. Hey, a different Burmy, there you go. We'll just go ahead and beat it, though. Because I don't need all the forms, I just need to get Burmy. For the sake of the Pokedex, there we go. Alright, across the bridge we go. We've already caught a Carnivine, so I'm not too worried about what this Carnivine says or does. Alright, Ember, because we do have to use Ember some as one of the tasks. I'm not going to do the task for all the Pokemon, but since Quilava's going to be with us pretty much the whole game, might as well. Alright, Carnivine's defeated. And there we go. I'm Kalaba, or Kalaba, that's probably how it is, Kalaba, of the Pearl Clan, Warden Kalaba to you. Oh, now would you look at that? You have a Celestica flute. You must be the one they say fell out of the space-time rift. I guess. Why the vague response? Something to hide? I've already heard about you, that you quelled Cleavor in his frenzy. I'm sure many people were saved by your actions.
but I wonder if there wasn't some other way to handle the situation. What you did is hardly different from bullying a Pokemon into submission, and you run about catching Pokemon up in those little balls you carry. I don't need any help from your sort, or the Diamond Clan for that matter. That young lady Erezu offered to help, but associating with the Diamond Clan, it just won't do. Be on your way. There is much I must do, and I'd prefer not to be distracted any further.
All right, old lady. Not my best old lady impression there, but you got the idea. Ah, Travis. How about you show me the strength that could quell even a frenzied lord? Sure, why not? Battle with you might let me experience even a fraction of the power the nobles wield. Ginkgo Guild member Volo challenges you to a battle. Togepi again. All right, Quilava. All right, Agile again. For the sake of having just a Agile Ember. All right, Strong Style Ember. There's a burn at least. Wow, he called Togepi back. All right, Gible. All right, Psyduck. Water Pulse. Oh, I got a critical hit. Okay. Staravia. Air Slash. All right. Alright, Togepi's got that burn. Okay. Air Slash it. Alright, Togepi goes down, we win. Oh my, you're quite adept at instructing your Pokemon in battle. My goodness, that was fun. Such prodigious strength. Now let me just heal up your Pokemon. Well now, I think that settles it. I must ask your help in retrieving the stolen wall fragment. With your skill, it should be a cinch. Wait, stolen? Yes, exactly. Some bandits pillaged the Salacion ruins and made off with a fragment of the wall engravings. Have you not heard of the notorious Misfortunes? They're a trio of bandits that have even hit us Ginkgo Guild merchants more than a few times. Not the kind of regulars I like to have, let me tell you. Mistress Calaba here, is doing everything she can to regain the fragment, but at 99 years old, it's a bit hard for her to chase leads all over the place. So what do you say, kind madam? Why not help find the fragment for the warden? Oh, naturally, I'll be happy to help lend you a hand. Those sisters swipe my wares, too, and I'm no Ginkgo Guild merchant if I take that lying down. And far be it from me to let them just get away with vandalizing the precious ruins of this region. You know, I did see the remains of a campfire near the Meyerlands camp, perhaps worth checking out. Alrighty. Do 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 do. All right, here we go. It's a burned out campfire. Now, who might you be? Not some stray traveler from the look of you. There's only one reason people go poking around here in the middle of nowhere. You're after us three, aren't you? Sisters, we should introduce ourselves properly before we show this poor fool how wrong she was to assume she could ever beat us. I bring good luck to my sisters wherever I go, and ill luck to anyone who crosses our paths. I'm the eldest, and I'll be your unlucky charm. Thought you spotted a four-leaf clover? Well, I'll soon have you seeing double. I'm the middle sister, and I'm one clover you can't pick. Heads I win and tails you lose. You've got no chance in this game of fortunes. I'm the youngest coin, but I'm definitely not your good luck piece. We're the infamous bandit trio, the Misfortune Sisters, and your luck's just run out. Let me handle this, sisters. I'll only hurt her a little. Come on, Toxicroak, let's douse this fool in poison. The Bandit Coin challenges us to a battle. Not a great start for us. Alright, Agile Amber. I'm an Amber. Ember. Not a whole lot to work with there. Flame Wheel. Critical hit, not enough though. We did burn it. That's all right. Good job, Quilava. Psyduck. Confusion. And there goes Toxicroak. I'm not fond of this outcome, but at least it's still better than plowing fields for the Galaxy team. Alright. The Galaxy team continues to spoil things for me, even after I've left. Take the blasted fragment and go. Just leave us alone. You obtained a wall fragment. The weird writing on it made us think the stupid thing was some kind of treasure, but it turned out to be a worthless slab of junk. All that effort for nothing. Tell me, why were you even seeking us out? What set you on this path? Goodness, how selfless of you to go so far out of your way for the sake of another. Not all of us have that luxury of offering such unthinkable kindness to strangers. For some of us, simply surviving another day takes all that we have. And I've got a score to settle with the Galaxy team, which now includes you. Remember what those ancient verses tell us. Why is it in days of spring, beneath the soft caress of the sun, the blossoms tremble and fall, spirits lashed by uncertainty? Your days are also numbered, Galaxy Fool. Alright, whatever. Too many trees. Alright, let's go heal up first. Alright, first I'm gonna put our shiny Ponyta where it is safe. As well as some of our other Pokemon here. Alright. I didn't heal after that. Okay. For a while. Alright. Let's go give that slab back to the ruins and we'll call it an episode. Good work, very good work indeed. You got the fragment back safe and sound. I'm well aware of Caliba's reputation. They say she's stubborn, too old-fashioned, and so on. But she's given the Pearl Clan all she has ever since she was young. She lived her prime years here in the Hisui region, trusting in the guidance of Almighty Sinnoh. I don't think it's that she hates the Diamond Clan or the Galaxy Team. Rather, I think she simply loves the Pearl Clan very, very much. Anyway, I do hope you're able to calm Ursaluna's frenzy. A raging Pokemon in the area definitely isn't good for business, I assure you. Alright. Hi, B-Barrel.
Oh, so you've come back to bother me again? Well, come as often as you'd like, but it won't change my mind.
Here's the wall fragment.
What? You went and retrieved the wall fragment? From those bandits? Why go out of your way like that for a complete stranger like me? I guess you're that eager to call Ursaluna, huh?
If possible.
I'll admit, I didn't expect anybody else to truly care for Ursaluna. Well then, let's see that wall fragment. And there we go. Good as new.
All lives touch other lives to create something anew and alive.
I'm going to read the same thing that he just read aloud. I suppose it means people helping each other, like how you helped retrieve the fragment. I've read this passage so many, many times, but this is the first time I've truly understood it. Maybe this is Almighty Sinnoh's guidance? What is your name, then? I see, Travish. Please lend me your strength, so that we may help Ursaluna.
I'm losing the voice a little bit.
It's true that Ursaluna has become enraged, but he didn't seem to be in an utter frenzy. I think he will return to his normal state if we could just give him some medicine. I could never bring myself to engage Pokemon in battle. But that's something I can rely on you for, am I right? Ursaluna prefers to stay on Sludge Mound. Please join me there when you're ready.
All right, if you liked what you saw here before and liked my terrible old lady impression, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, you know, all that YouTube nonsense, and I'll see you next time with another episode of Pokemon Legends Arceus. All right, bye-bye.